Hey guys, I was just cleaning out the shed and working in there, and I came across this old radio again. I'd forgotten all about it, actually. That's something we like to do. I go to a lot of yard sales, flea markets, auctions, all kind of stuff, and because I really do, you know, like, there's a lot of antiques I think are just so cool, and that they don't design things like that anymore. And so when I come across something that's interesting, if it's affordable, you know, I'll pick it up, as long as we have space to put it and that kind of thing. Anyway, this old radio I thought I'd show you because it's kind of neat. This is a 19, from what I can gather, it's a 1926 Kolster radio. It's a 6D model. And, you know, and honestly, I think it's made by Federal Telegraph Company. And that's about all I know about it, but maybe some of you out there know more about them than me. I'll try to show you some of the dials and everything here. And this top, I got it more for like a display piece, and at the last place I lived in, I used this for just sort of a decorative piece in the living room. It was just kind of sitting on a table over in the corner. And as a result, I've never even tried to get it to work or anything. The top here flips up, and that's where, I don't know if this thing will focus good enough, but if you can see, it's got all the information about the patents and what type of radio it is, that kind of thing. And even back in here, it's got a little instruction manual kind of thing, and it's pretty informative, really. It shows you how everything's wired. It has like a multi-plug setup and explains all that. I'll show you that here in a second. And you can see that it's got the old glass tubes in here. And one guy was telling me that even there's some people out there that collect just those tubes. Sometimes they have some value in them just for that. You know, when I bought it, I just thought it was kind of good looking, nice design on the outside. And then I liked the fact that that top popped open like that. And I figured, if it was just completely shot, I was going to take the radio components out of it, actually, and just so I have a hollow box. And then I was just going to kind of repurpose it for some other use, you know, to store things in or what have you. But anyway, it actually seemed pretty complete when I got it home, so I decided to leave it alone because I would hate to gut something out like that and then find out that there's collectors out there that are just dying to have them, you know. So anyway, I've left it this way so far. Everything's pretty much as it was when I bought it. Give you a little look inside here for anybody that's into these sorts of things. Yeah, there we go. Got a little focus. And your six tubes and everything. And then this plug back here. If I can get that on there. Set it out here on the table. It's just a snake of wires, but they actually all do have connectors on them. There's various styles of connectors, I assume for, according to the instructions in there, actually, it's for various types of batteries that were available at the time. And I don't know, maybe somebody out there, maybe you know, if there's still places out there to find batteries for these things. And also, is there any shops out there that are still testing these tubes, and you know, somebody could actually tell me if this thing will work, because it is kind of a neat old radio. And and also, if anybody knows, you can comment. Is there any value to these radios? I mean, I have no idea. I kind of looked around on the internet a little bit, but it's hard to find any records of anybody putting these up for sale or anything. So not that I'm planning on doing anything with it, but just kind of neat to know what I have. But anyway, like I said, the most I know is it's a 1926 Kolster, and it was 60, and it's made by Federal Telegraph Company. And anyway, I just thought I was, I had it out in the garage for a little bit for whatever reason, and I just decided to just take it back in the house. I'm going to dust it off, and we'll find a little better place for it in there. And anyway, so I thought on my way in, I would just show you guys so you can get a look at it. Got a Harley going by. Anyway, so I'll see you guys later. Bye.